Hello, Kusto community. My name is Ryan Jittimer, and I'm a product manager on the Azure Synapse Analytics team. Today, I'm joined by Dany Hoter, who's a program manager from the Azure Data Explorer team, for another episode of Azure Data Explorer 101. Today's topic is aggregations in Power BI. I'm going to hand it over to Dany for him to introduce himself. Welcome.
Hello. In this video, I want to show you the basic of connecting from Power BI desktop to data in the Kusto, also known as the Azure Data Explorer. We're going to do the basic ways to connect and use the data. And in subsequent videos, we're going to go into more advanced scenarios. But let's start. So I already started Power BI, and I'm going to get data. Here, I'm going to look for the connector. There's a lot of connectors. One of them is the connector to Kusto. So I'm starting to write Kusto. I'm seeing the connector I want, and I'm clicking OK. Here, there's a dialog with a few fields in it. The only mandatory field is the name of the cluster or the address of the cluster. I'm going to use in my examples the help cluster, which is available to you or to anyone who uses Kusto, and I can just write help, and that will be it. Or I can actually go and look for the full address that I copied before from the Explorer and put it here. So you can put here the cluster, one of your clusters, the free cluster that you created, or a cluster existing in your organization. Then I would recommend scrolling down to the bottom of this dialog and looking at the selection between data connectivity mode, between import and direct query. And in most cases, I would recommend using direct query because the whole point of using data in Kusto is that you have large quantities of data, large volume. Could be you have billions of rows, many, many, many tens of billions even, and you definitely don't want to import all these rows into Power BI. And also, by using direct query, you're guaranteed to get the fresh data, data that maybe arrived into Kusto half a minute ago, and not rely on periodical imports of data to Power BI. So I can also use some of the other columns if I want, fields here if I want to. I can put the name of the database, and I can also go to the Explorer and bring a query. So here I have a query that I created and I ran, and I know it's working well, and it's so I can copy it and go back to Power BI here and paste it here. In this case, I will have to bring the right database name also. But in my case, I don't want to do that. I just want to use navigate to the list of tables and start from there. So I'm just doing direct query, and I'm clicking OK. Now I'm going to see the contents of the cluster that I connected to, and the content is a list of databases. In this case, I'm going to use the Contoso Sales database. And I see that it contains a few tables. All these first ones are tables. And then there are functions. We talk about functions in one of the subsequent videos because they're really very, very useful. But we start just by using a table called Sales Table. And this table, I can see here a preview of this table, and I can go directly into Transform. This is a table that when I actually ingested it into Power BI, into Kusto, I already included everything I needed for a report. So data that came originally from multiple tables was joined together into one table, so I can use it here. Now, I can start doing here transformations the same way I do with any other source. For example, I see that there's a lot of rows which have null for first name, last name, and so on. And maybe I don't want this rows, so I can say filter here, text filters. I want to filter out or to see only rows which the name is not equal to null. So now it's refreshing the preview and I see only those rows. I can also go and remove some rows and say some columns. Click here, click here, right click, remove. I can also go and add columns. I can say I want to take the first name and the last name and go to add columns, and I want to create a column which is those two merged together with a space between, and I want to call it full name. So regular operations that we do with the Power Query in within Power BI, and I see here the steps, and every step here is actually building the KQL that will eventually be sent to bring the data. If I want to see the KQL and I'm interested, I can right click here and say view native query, and I can look at the query that was actually generated by the connector to filter out the rows with null and also to create the full name, etc. Everything is translated to native KQL. Once I'm happy with what the transformations, it's okay for me. I can go to home, close and apply. Now this apply will be very fast because I'm not bringing in any rows. I'm just creating the metadata with the structure of the table. And I see here the list of columns, and I can start building my report again in a usual way I will do with Power BI, nothing special here. For example, I can create a slicer, move to the slicer the column of country. Now we'll see a list of all countries. I can select one of them. Now I can maybe drag the state column into the canvas, and I see immediately the states of Germany because I'm selecting here Germany. And if I want, I can drag here the salesman column, and now the size of the bubble represents the size, the volume of sales for each one of the states. And if I click here to switch to United States, now it's the same just with the United States. So everything is normal behavior of Power BI. The only difference is because I'm using direct query against Kusto, then every click here, if I want to see now, for example, United States and Canada, in the time between I clicked and the time the visual, the map refreshed, there was a query sent to Kusto to summarize the data for all the states of the United States and Canada, all the numbers brought into Power BI, and Power BI was rendering this report. And you saw that this is actually very fast. So you can use this with data, which is here that we have a few million rows, but it could be much bigger. And you can use in this mode Power BI with large volumes of data. The next videos on this topic will go into more advanced scenarios on Power BI and Kusto. Thanks.
Well, thanks for joining us, Dany. Tell us in the comments, do you use Power BI with Azure Data Explorer? I'd love to hear about it. Again, my name is Ryan Benjitimer. You can find me on Twitter. You can also find Azure Data Explorer on Twitter. AZ Data Explorer. Like, comment, subscribe. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one.